This is exactly why I say that these new black and brown entrepreneurs, if you're not careful, most of them are becoming to be worse than our actual slave masters. They pay you under what you want to be paid. They're the new slave masters. Mm-hmm. I pay you less than what you're worth, under what you value, with the perception telling you I don't have any money while I'm on a jet, I'm on vacations, and you slaving for me. I'm paying you less than your value, and I'm making you feel worse than what you are. You're not a CEO yet until you realize that being a CEO is servitude. That's the moment you let go of just me, and now you start saying we, collectively. You're now the representation of a company of people that you represent, that represent their families. And this is why so many people don't want to work for companies. Can I tell you something, Jay? Most people actually want to work with a group. People like consistent income. But what people want to know is that, is my consistent income limited? Can I grow to what I want to become? Can I be who I want to be? Is the development there? And is your ego gone long enough? Is your ego gone long enough that if I do surpass you, will you pass the baton? And if people really understood that, a lot of people will realize that extremely talented black, white, and Puerto Rican, Asian, Hispanic people would love to come and work with you if they knew that those things that I just mentioned was a part of the list and the ego was gone. I can be replaced at any time, the moment that any one of my teammates, not my employees, we're teammates, can be better than me in all the areas that I'm great at for this company. I will remove. It ain't nepotism. My children don't get first rights. The best person gets first rights. You know what that tells him and his son and him and his daughter? That if my daughter or me are better for the position, we will be in position. How can you build something great when you're the only one that's great about it? So when I say you're not a CEO, it's because it's the premise of God-like understanding. God moves through people to get a job done. Jonathan, I can't reach that executive Bible. Can you pass it to me? Did I move?
Not at all.
But the work got done, right?
That's right.
You know what most CEOs did? I passed myself this. I'm self-made. I wrote the book. I passed myself the book. Or I can say, if it wasn't for Jonathan passing me this book, I wouldn't be able to talk about this book in front of you right now. What would that make you feel if you were working on my team?
I feel acknowledged.
Then if I say, hey, any intellectual property you create with my brand and my company, you own it and we participate as co-owners with what you created. What would you then say?
Let's do it.
Oh. If I say every podcast that you put in place, you get a piece of every podcast past what I paid you to do the job. How often would you do the podcast?
Every day.
That's what being a CEO means. It's understanding that people are giving you their best and they expect for you to do the same. And most of us are not CEOs yet until we can recognize and understand that this is the people business that we're in. And the more you take care of your people, the longer your people will take care of you. And yes, I take less money up front, but in the end, my children will forever be taken care of because my team that's around me, they all been with me nearly a decade. You think any of them gonna let any of my children starve, bro? Absolutely not. When I die, 100% of my death benefit goes to the company.